some other stories like that, and they're out there, we will find them. And I'm going to find enough of them to build a huge business. And by the time I become extremely successful, making six figures, I'm going to have so much significance in so many people's lives. But I'm going to look at my life first every morning in the mirror and say, I have a model of success. I got to be doing everything every single day. I need a game plan. I need to live it every single day. I need to model it every day. At the end of 30 days, I need to look back and I need to be creating businesses indebted to me because I did so much for so many people, for my wife, for my family, for my kids. Because let me tell you something, guys. Those of you that have kids that are old enough to get this business, they get it. And they know what time it is. And you can only say, I'm going to be there someday so many times. And we go out and we tell our children, go succeed, get A's, do your best, always do your best. And they're watching you, mom and dad. What are you doing? Right? They know. They get it. This guy in my business, I'll close with this. This guy in my business used to, he called me up once and we were at his house. When I was in the business, we used to do this thing where we'd go to a guy's house and pack his wife, we'd buy magazines and we cut out frames and we put them all in the refrigerator. It's a big deal. And so I remember going there one night and we just called, putting all the drains on the refrigerator and we're cutting out things. And we'd always put them up high, and then when they had kids that rolled up, the kids would cut out their drains and they'd be low in the refrigerator. So it was just this giant refrigerator of his dreams. I remember spending the whole evening with his kids, and they were saying, oh, I want a pony, and they cut out a pony. And it was just a pretty fun time. And I remember about a year after the business started, he called me one night, and he goes, Greg, he says, I can't do this anymore. I go, why? He goes, it's just so hard for me. I go, why? Because he goes, I'm just so afraid all the time. I don't know who to, I can't talk to people. And he'd been in the business a year. He said, I'm going to quit. You know what I said to him? His name was Jim. I said, Jim, don't tell me. I want you to have a meeting tonight. I want you to bring your family back into that refrigerator. I want you to stand up in front of that refrigerator. I want you to start taking your dreams off one at a time. And I want you to explain to them how this is too tough. Life's just too tough, kids. This is too hard a journey for me. And I said that when you're done, I want you to tell the kids to start peeling theirs off, the lower part of that refrigerator. Because someday, Jim is today. And your kids know what life's about. And you're a dreamer. And you're teaching them dreaming. And you're mentoring those children. And you know what, Jim, I gotta tell you something. If you can do that, that takes so much more strength to ever do that than I would ever be to build this business. That would take so much more effort, so much more power and strength that you can stand in front of your children and start feeding their dreams about that refrigerator. Well, I don't know, some of you here today, you may not have dreams